Curtis, what day is it? Is it Thursday? I think it's Thursday, May 9th, 1990. No, it's May 10th. In a few more months.
I guess she'll die. We have a story at our school. It's a story about an old grandma pulling a cow and a horse. But the horse was too big, then she died. I don't have any boots, I can't find them.
Yeah, these are some nice sturdy trees yesterday.
Yeah, well now they're not because they all broke down. We're gonna have to take all our trees down now, right Daddy?
Yeah.
All hundreds of these trees down. And it's a good thing we got.
Yeah. Here's our backyard now.
Gosh!
Look at our rhubarb.
That's even junk of my sand.
Yeah.
See?
Yep, look at your sand. It's now a lake.
Oh, good. Now I can play with that like a boat.
Oh, man. Look at that big one there.
Just those little shoes on.
Yeah, look at that deer tracks. Just everywhere. Thousands of them.
Tons of them. Zillions.
Yeah, our backyard's a little different now, huh?
Jake, can I take a look at it? Head off, because that's cement, and you might slip and fall on your butt on that. Because you might hurt yourself when you're making a hole in your butt.
Can I take a look again?
Daddy, can I take a look again?
Everywhere you look. Yeah.
I can take this thing! This would be not heavy. Hi, Daddy. Why don't you take a picture of me? Take a skunk out of it! Mom! Take a skunk out of it!
Dear friends, today we come jointly to acknowledge and witness the marriage of James Edward Antone and Linda Sue Eddington. They have learned to know and to love each other, and they have decided to become husband and wife. To this moment, they bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure to share with one another. They bring the dreams which bind them together, and they bring that particular personality and spirit which is uniquely their own, and out of which will grow the reality of their life together. So let us join Jim and Linda on this their special day by first recognizing the true source of all love. Let us be mindful that we are in the presence of God and immersed in the Holy Spirit of life, love, and wisdom. We acknowledge your presence and your power, O Blessed Spirit, and your divine wisdom. Erase our mortal limitations, and from your pure substance of love, bring into expression our world according to your perfect law. Amen. Who presents this bride in marriage?
My wife and my child.
Jim and Linda, marriage can be a great adventure when it is the outward expression of a great love. Such love allows each of you to see through to your partner's essence and to totally support your partner's well-being, goals, purpose, and spirit. But love is not total absorption in each other. It is looking outward in the same direction together. Love does not imply ownership or possession. Rather, at the end of this ceremony, you will be husband and wife, but you must choose each day to be married. And as you do so, your unchanging commitment to your love will allow you to experience the love. You may now silently concentrate and dedicate yourself to your marriage promises to love, while we hold you lovingly in our lives. And I ask all of you here today to also dedicate yourself to supporting Jim and Linda and the marriage vows they are making today. Dedicate yourselves to encouraging them to the loving times, the trying times, the ebb and the flow of life, pledging them the lifelong support of your love. Where the Christ enters in, there is love. Where the Christ enters in, there is patience, dignity, and honor. Where the Christ enters in, life looks forth into the fullness of its promise. And as a man and woman come together in love, they experience true communion. And by their communion, they become aware of the deepest spiritual reality of life. The bond uniting you is a holy union of hearts, minds, souls, and lives, joined together and strengthened by our Creator as well as yourselves. And you enhance this bond, and now make your promises of love and truth. James Edward Antone, will you have Linda Sue Eddington as your wife? Share your life openly with her. Speak with her in love. To honor and defend her and care for her. Cherish and encourage her fulfillment as an individual through all the changes of your life. Amen. Linda Sue Eddington, will you have James Edward Antone as your husband? Share your life openly with him. Speak the truth to him in love. Honor and tenderly care for him. Cherish and encourage his fulfillment as an individual through all the changes of your life. by their shape, are a symbol of eternity, without beginning or end, and a true emblem of the undying of the sufferings of which they are composed is a symbol of purity, which will characterize your minds and hearts in all your endeavors. Father, Mother God, I ask that you bless these rings and those who will wear them all. All the treasures of my mind, heart, by the authority vested in me, in the name of the God of love, who is present in every true marriage, James Edward Antle and Linda Sue Eddington, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Bless this loving wife. Bless her and give her a tenderness that will make her great, a deep sense of understanding, and a great faith in you. Give her that inner beauty of soul that never fades. May these marriage partners never expect that perfection of each other that belongs to you alone. May they minimize each other's weaknesses, be swift to praise and magnify each other's beauty and strength. May they always see each other through a lover's kind and patient eyes. Now make such assignments to them as will bless them and develop their character as they walk together. Give them enough tears to keep them tender. Give them enough hurts to keep them humane. Give them enough of failure to keep their hands clenched tightly in words. But also give them enough joy and success so they will know you love them and walk with them always. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Edward Antle. James, ladies and
Oh, that's great.
Squeeze my hand.
Yeah, we gotta get in closer.
Maybe we met my boyfriend as usual.
Now before we eat, Donna would like to say something. I suggest we eat.
She's fixing herself. number two.
There's one of the bears.
This guy here just got
here. We'll get him later.
That's his sister-in-law. That's...
Which is that?
That's so cute.
Which is that?
Yeah.
What?
Dad.
And the wine glass.
And yeah, the wine glass.
It's your turn.
Glasses.
Yeah.
The bottle of your wine glass.
Wow.
This is when Kathy makes dinner.
You don't know what you want.
Where are your glasses?
No. The glasses. The champagne.
Yeah, I know. I'm asking him where his glasses are because he can't see it.
I'm thinking of
Ariel, she's a change woman.
Hey, it's shrimp there.
That's a trick.
Yeah, that's my shrimp dog.
I'm going to get on the
Davis.